Hi, I'm Mamta, PGT Psychology. Today we'll be doing Chapter 2, Self and Personality. This carries a weightage of 10 marks from the board point of view. Let's look at the concept of self and the concept of personality. Now, self basically addresses the question of who am I? If I have to describe about myself, that is what my self is. The image that I carry about myself is my concept of the self. Let's look at the definition. Self refers to a totality of an individual's conscious experiences, ideas, thoughts, and feelings with regard to himself or herself. So what you think about yourself, the total experiences, the total thoughts, the total ideas about whom you think you are is known as the self. Now, how does it develop? It basically develops from your interaction with other significant people in your life, your parents, your friends, your neighbors, your relatives, your teachers. These are important people in your life. If they tell you something, it stays on with you and you start thinking in that direction. Am I like that? Why did they keep mentioning about me like that? So all that impression stays on with you and you organize that experience about who you are. Let's look at the dual state of the self, self as a subject and self as an object. As a subject, it's about the actor that you are, the doer, the knower. That means if I say I'm a good dancer, that is about the actor that I am or the subject of the self. The other is the object, the consequences, the known or the thoughts and feelings. If I say I got hurt, that is something which is an object. Feelings, consequences, the known. Let's move on to the next, which is the kinds of self. Now, self has two major kinds, personal self and social self. Personal self lays emphasis on those aspects of life that are only concerned to the person. For instance, personal freedom, personal responsibility, personal achievements, personal comforts in relation to himself. Next is social, familial or relational self. We use the three names for the same concept. The emphasis is here on social aspects of life. For example, cooperation, unity, attachments with other people, compromising for other people and sharing for other people. Let's move on to the kinds of identity. We have again the same kinds of identity like we had the kinds of self, personal identity and social identity. If somebody asks you your name, that is your personal identity. If somebody asks you about your qualities, that is your personal identity. So the attributes or qualities of a person that make him or her different from others. Social identity, who am I in context of society? Am I a North Indian? Am I a Hindu? That is my link to my cultural and social group. Let's move on to the cognitive and behavioral aspects of self. Now, cognitive aspects includes two concepts here. It talks about self-concept and it talks about self-esteem. Now, self-concept is basically the image that I carry about myself. I am a good poet. I am good at maths. I am good at sports. I am average at the other areas. That is self-concept. The other is self-esteem. Esteem basically means your worthiness. What do I value myself? Do I think I'm capable? My judgment about my own self is known as a self-esteem. Now, this develops in four different areas. It talks about social competence, cognitive competence, physical appearance and physical competence. These are the four areas in which it starts developing right from 7 years of age. And how does it develop? Well, parenting plays a very important role here. Suppose the parents try and intervene in the way a child studies or the time that the child devotes to play or his friends. Normally, the children do not like it. But at the same time, if their intervention is restrictive, when they criticize the child, when they reject the child, when they pass comments on the child, well, the idea and the intention of the parents here is perfectly fine because they want the child to improve. But that may not be the natural style of the child. And of course, look at the kind of impact it has on the psyche of the child. The child believes what the parent says. If the parents say, you cannot do it, the child believes it to be true. So this is where the role of parenting develops self-esteem. Next concept, which comes in the behavioral aspect, the actual behavior, self-efficacy and self-regulation. Now, there was a great psychologist, a great behaviorist, Albert Bandura. He has given this concept of self-efficacy, meaning thereby, do I think I can control the situations? Do I think I'm effective? What do I think about my ability to do a task? For instance, a girl who doesn't really study much, but when she's asked questions, she has the thought that I can definitely answer. If I'm asked questions, I will have the ability and the capacity to answer and justify myself. That is the thought about whether you are effective, whether you will be able to handle that situation or not. That is self-efficacy. Last concept here is self-regulation. Now, this concept, when we talk about it, basically means, am I able to regulate my behavior? Now, this has four parts. This is how you develop self-regulation, by instructing yourself, self-instruction, by rewarding yourself. Suppose I have been able to keep a fast for the whole day. I reward myself the next day. I have been able to achieve my target for the studies for today. I reward myself. Next is, obviously, you have to observe your own behavior also. Only then you will be able to regulate it. Next concept is culture and self. Now, again, we talk about the Indian perspective and the Western perspective. Indian perspective, we have a collectivist culture. We have a culture where the boundary between an individual and a society is not fixed. It is not separated. So both exist in harmonious coexistence. This is where myself develops from my cultural influence. Western perspective, if I want to achieve, I want to succeed in life, I want to look at my fun, my partying, or my life, I don't want my children to be a part of my life. That is Western perspective, where you as a person and your society, your culture, people around you, there's a clear demarcation. That's about the two concepts. We move on to the concept of personality. Now, we've done the concept of self. Now, let's understand what is personality. Let me ask you this question. If you look at any film star, if you look at any sports person, you have a sudden judgment that they are having a good personality. Now, is personality only about the physical appearance, the way they carry themselves, or is there more to it? What do psychologists think here? Now, personality as a term emerged from a word persona, which was used in Roman theatre, where it was a mask. On the stage, the actors used a mask to reflect themselves, to understand different roles, to get into the skin of different roles. And this is where personality came in from. Okay, let me ask you a question here. If you are you the same kind of person with everybody around, with your friends, the best of your friends, with your teacher, with your parents, with your cousins? Are you the same person? Well, you are the same person by and large. Your characteristics don't change. They are stable. But yes, the combination of those characteristics changes. For instance, a very, very dominating person is working with a very dominating boss. Now, in this case, only one of them can be dominating. So the employee has to sober down a bit, has to express in a different manner from the way he normally does. He might be dominating at home, but at work, he knows his limits. So this is where, in a certain situation, the behavior changes. Your genes give you a certain personality, but do you get a chance to develop that personality determined by your environment? Okay, let's look at the definition. Personality refers to our characteristics, way of behaving or responding to individuals and to situations. So definitely, we will not keep changing every day with every person. But yes, we do change our mask with a different kind of people. It means you are unique. Obviously, the combination of characteristics gives you a uniqueness. And these qualities are very much stable. They are your characteristics. You are not created in the form of somebody else. It's only you. The qualities that you have, maybe the other person doesn't have it in the same combination. So it's only you as a unique being. Okay, let's look at the characteristics of personality here. It has both physical and psychological components. Physical we understood as the physical appearance. Psychological we understood as somebody who is shy, somebody who is honest, somebody who is an extrovert, somebody who is, you know, having an honest opinion about things. All of that is a part of physical and psychological components. Second, its expression in terms of behavior is fairly unique in the given individual. That is what we talk about, that you are a unique personality, you are a unique being. So therefore, the qualities that you have express itself to give you this subjectivity. Next, its main features do not easily change with time. Just imagine if our personality keeps changing, we will have a disorder. So therefore, there has to be a stability in us. The characteristics are there, only the level of those characteristics might vary depending on the people that you interact with. Last, it is dynamic in the sense that some of its features may change due to internal or external situational demands. That is where we say personality is adaptive to different situations. So by and large, when we talk about the stability, the consistency of the characteristics that we have, we are born with it. If I am an honest person, nobody can force me to lie. And in a situation which is in which I really have to lie, I will be having guilt about lying. So I am not a real liar. It is only to defend myself if I am lying, I will not be too happy about it. So this is where my uniqueness lies, that these are the set of qualities that we have. So today we understood the concept of self and the concept of personality. Let's understand the relation between the two concepts. Self is basically my experience, the totality of my thoughts, the total experience I have, the total feelings I have, the total ideas that I have. So it's a totality, a composite, a holistic picture of who am I, the me in me and who am I. Then personality as such is dealing with your uniqueness, your qualities, the way you behave in different situations. Now, we are born with a certain traits, certain characteristics through which we behave, which is common to most of the situations. But yes, it can vary depending on the situation and the circumstances. But the definition remains constant, that it is a stable characteristic aspect or a pattern of your personality, which is constant, which is stable. Except, of course, when you have to adapt to different situations, when you have to deal with different situations, and that will require a little change in you because you do not behave like that normally. The normal behavior is very comfortable for you. You have been comfortable with it. You have been behaving it automatically and regularly. But when you have to adapt to the environment, that is not your quality, you have to adapt to it, then it becomes a problem. A little modification is required. Okay, to summarize, when we talk about the concept of self and the concept of personality, we try to understand the concept of self in a great detail. We started with the definition of self, the concept of self. Then we moved on to the two dual aspects of the self which is a subject, the known, the actor, the self which is an object, which is a knower, which is consequences. From that, we try to understand the two kinds of self, the qualities of me, that is personal qualities, and the qualities for people around me, the way I behave dealing with others. That is a social self, or what I am born with, the culture I am born with. From that, we moved on to the types of identity, again personal identity and social identity. And from there, we try to understand the two aspects of self, the thought related, the mind related, the idea related, self-concept and self-esteem. Then behavioral, we did self-regulation and self-efficacy. And of course, we understood the concept of personality. That's about it for today. Thank you.